My name is Raafat El-Namaky. I'm from Egypt. I'm a breast breeder with AfricaRice. I start since October 2009. For hybrid race technology, China is the first country who start this technology is almost around 1960. And they start to do commercialism for hybrid race on a large scale in 1980. The yield increase for hybrid race in China, they say it can feed enough 70 million people. Because now hybrid it cover 50% from the total area in China, which is almost 15 million hectare by hybrid rice. After that, in 1980, some Asian countries they start to transfer this technology. Philippines, Vietnam, Thailand, many Asian countries, India, they grow now more than 1 million hectare for hybrid rice. In 1995, Egypt started their program for hybrid rice, and they will succeed to release the first hybrid in 2002. For Africa, rice will start this program in 2010. 2009, Africa Rice and ERI and Chinese of Academy of Agriculture Science, they start project it called Green Super Rice. It has hybrid rice activities. 2009-2010, they start do evaluation of some hybrid from developed by China. It show very good yield, but the problem it was susceptible to disease, especially Africa Rice Gold Midge and RYMV. This encouraged Africa Rice to start their breeding program for hybrid rice. In 2010, Africa Rice joined Hybrid Rice Development Consortium at ERI, was able to access for some material to do screening and evaluation in our condition here. Also, we do our breeding, creating breeding population to develop our restorer maintainer lines and the CMS lines. We start 2010 through this two-line system, and by 2013 we was able to start to develop our hybrids. We start to do evaluation here in Senegal, and also we extend to do our evaluation with our partner in Mali, Gambia, and Mauritania. 2014 we start to do also evaluation in Nigeria, and this year we start to send evaluation, do evaluation for our hybrid in Kenya and Uganda. The advantage for our breeding program here, we do all evaluation and all breeding is in our condition here. As we indicate for green super rice, it was good, very good yield, but the problem it was susceptible to disease and insect. We start to do our evaluation through breeding task force at Africa Rice, and now we develop almost 500 hybrids. We was able to do only test for almost around 40 or 50 hybrids. This is due to limited of budget, but we hope for next year we can do more evaluation with our partner. If we succeed to release our hybrids here, so we can produce the seeds in our local condition here in Senegal or Mali. As you know, many Chinese or Indian company or some company from Asia, they do evaluation for their hybrid in Africa. But the problem, even if this hybrid show a big advantage, they need to deliver the seeds from Asia every year to Africa. And this, it will transfer the disease from Asia to Africa. As you know, the disease in Asia, like Tongro or some virus disease, is easy to transfer to Africa through the seeds. And this really, it is very dangerous. This is why when even we start a Green Super Rice project, we insist, even if Indian or Chinese or Asian seed company interest to do their business on hybrid rice in Africa, they need to do the seed production in Africa. They have to produce the seeds local here. At least also private seed company, the local seed company here, they can be trained on hybrid seed production and hybrid rice technology. And this will be efficient way. Because if we still deliver the seeds from Asia, we will not transfer the technology. For example, about 50 candidates from Africa, they train on hybrid rice in China every year. In the past 25 years, more than 2,000 candidates trained on hybrid rice. But when you come the impact for this training is almost zero, because we don't see any country release hybrid or hybrid don't cover any area in those country. This is why we need training. Yeah, training can be done in China, but after training we should apply the technology. This is our target, to transfer the technology. It's easy to get hybrid to do and do adaptation, but hybrid, because you need the seed to renew the seeds every year, so you need to do access for the seeds. We cannot be waiting to import the seeds every year from Asia, from this company, from India or China or any seed company. This is why AfricaRice, when they started the program, we work with our partner to do evaluation in their country. And also, if any country interest to have their own breeding program, we support them. For example, Mali, they have a small project funded by WAP. AfricaRice support Mali now to do their breeding program on hybrid rice. Last week, Dulu, who was here, he do selection for our hybrid. He have also training on hybrid rice by AfricaRice. Also, we are going there to support them for technical support on hybrid rice. So this is the best way. And even for all those hybrid, AfricaRice is ready to share the parental lines with the private and the public sector in Africa. What we need to insist, seed production should be done at least in the region. For example, Senegal can be produced seeds for Gambia or Mauritania in the region here, or Mali, because the condition is almost the same. But we cannot export seeds even from West Africa to East Africa. Seeds we need to produce in the region, in the local condition. This is why we need to work with our partner more to show the advantage of the hybrids, and after that it go for hybrid seed production. As I mentioned, we started the evaluation since 2013. For example, here in Senegal, we do the participatory varietal selection in 2014-2015. Farmers, they select 5 hybrids. We do demonstration in farmer field. For example, this year, it was almost around 10 farmers in Fanai and Ghana, even in Jaeher also. ISRA, I now start the process for release for 2 hybrids. Is selected by farmer. This hybrid is AR0 Tranda, is high yielding variety, high yielding hybrids, and AR051, this is aromatic hybrid. We are starting now to preparing to submit these 2 hybrids for release with ISRA. Also, for seed production, we do 2 training course for seed producer and some seed company here to start to produce the hybrid seeds. Maybe now we don't have enough budget to go for mini country or to go for commercial scale, but I believe within next 2-3 years, AfricaRice with our partner will find way for those hybrid to go outside to cover large scale with the hybrids. Okay, the next step now for AfricaRice, we'll need to organize the regional workshop for hybrid rice. We invite public and private sector, even our partner from Asia, all people who interest to work on hybrid rice in Africa. Because AfricaRice, we cannot insist for hybrid seed production to be done by only local seed company, but also we encourage the seed company from Asia, Chinese or Indian, seed company to come to work with us. They have more experience, they have more capacity for hybrid seed production, but we'll ask them to do their production here. For hybrids, also we start to develop hybrid for irrigated condition, but also this second phase for us to have hybrid more tolerant for drought and salinity. Which also be our target in this phase, develop hybrid more tolerant for drought and salinity ecology. Also for local seed producer, we need to start training on hybrid seed production. We know many of them, they don't have idea yet. Maybe they don't have, they will need technical support, but we need to show them the advantage of the hybrid rice. This is the best way to encourage them to go on the system. As I mentioned, last week we have field day. We visited the demonstration plot of hybrid rice in the farmer field in Fanai and Dagana. In their field, in the farmer field, we expect for the hybrids to have minimum between like 11, 12 ton per hectare in their plot, in the farmer field. And of course, this, it can be like average. Farmer, when they ask us, what is the potential for hybrids? Potential for hybrid can be 13, 14 ton per hectare. But when it comes to the average, we say between 10 and 12 ton per hectare. This is the average. But also, hybrid rice, it need good management to show the advantage and the hybrid vigor. Farmers, they ask us, what is the yield and what is the advantage for compared to the inbred line? We say to them, hybrid give at least minimum 1 ton or 1.5 ton advantage compared to the inbred lines. This is advantage for yield is coming without any extra cost. It need only to renew the seeds every year. And if you go for hybrid system, this will force the farmer to use certified seeds. As we know, one of our main problem here in the Sahel and many African country, we develop and release many variety, but farmer, they still use their own seeds from their own field. So we have the variety, good variety, it has good yield potential, but farmer, they don't go for certified seeds. But if they go for the hybrid, there's no way, they have to go for certified seeds every year. And of course, this system, it will be like good opportunity for the seed company and for the good to do good business and also to employ young generation, because for hybrid seed production need more technician for seed production, more labor, so at least will not have problem to find job for them. Okay, for green quality of hybrid rice, we conduct analysis for green quality here in San Luis and Cotonou. We estimate the MLS content, milling percentage, and of course, our selected hybrid, as we see for the two selected hybrid, one of them is aromatic, and this is for, I think, this trait give more advantage for the hybrid because many consumer in many regions, for example, even West and East Africa, they prefer the aromatic variety. Even milling percentage for the selected hybrid, it is more than 60%. It is 66 or 67% for the milling percentage. And also, most of our selected hybrid, it is long and extra long grain. We have different type from the hybrids, but we start to do the test in West Africa here. But even still, if some region prefer, for example, short or medium grains, we have many hybrids. The next step now, through SRDC project, we are going to do dissemination for our material in many country. Because, as I mentioned, we developed 500 hybrids, we was able only to test 50 hybrids. So we still have huge stock of our hybrid. For example, this year, we received contact from Cote d'Ivoire, from Uganda, from Nigeria, the interest to test our hybrid. So now we start preparing the seeds. Of course, for each country, they have their own preference. So based on their selection, in their condition, and also consumer and seed producer, farmer, all those, it will be involved for evaluation and selection of hybrid rice. So based on their selection, we'll be able to do production for the selected hybrid rice. Yeah, as we mentioned, the main advantage for hybrid rice is green yield. But also hybrid has another advantage. As we know, for weed is a big problem for the rice cultivation, especially with the direct seeds. But if we look for the hybrid, all hybrid show high seedling vigor. So this, it show more competitive with the weeds. So when it comes with the weeds, hybrid, it will be like more competitive with the weeds because the seedling vigor, it is higher. So this hybrid will try to avoid this problem. Also, for the hybrids, it is for the duration. the two selected hybrid almost the same duration with the earliest variety, Sahel 108, even earlier. For example, in dry season, it can be around 125 days. For wet season, it's almost between 15 and 110 days. So this is very early hybrids. And this, it assists farmer to have two crop per season, especially here in West Africa for the Sahel region. It's cold season now is from December up to February. So this is affects the farmer. They delay the sowing date for the dry season till March. And if they start in March, if the variety is not early, farmers, they cannot easy to go for the second crop. So if you have short duration variety, it's easy to have two crop per season. Even farmer, they will get this cold season from December to February, 3 months, they can grow vegetable. So this for the farmer, it is very interesting for them. We have some hybrid, it's very early maturing. For wet season, it was almost 90 to 100 days. From seeds till maturity, from 90 to 100 days. And for dry season, it was almost 110 days. So this two hybrid, yield is not very high, but at least is the same with the Czech. So if, for example, but this is different hybrid. So at least this set of the hybrid, we call early maturing hybrid, it has advantage at least 2 weeks compared with the Czech variety. And this 2 weeks for wet season, 2 weeks for dry season, it will help the farmer to grow two crop per season and also can grow vegetable between the two crop.